evening, everybody. Thank you all for being here. My name is Trevor Gipper. This is my senior recital as a student at ASU. So I'd like to introduce my band really quick. We have Max Beckman on bass, Jimmy Barrios on trumpet, Tyler Bauer on tenor sax, and Reed Ridia on guitar. So I have some interesting stories behind most of the tunes that I selected tonight, but to keep the night short, I'll try to keep them moving along quickly. But this is a tune off of an album by the Phoenix Jazz Quartet, written by Armin Boatman, who's a local piano player. And I listen to KJZZ a lot, and something off this record was being played on there, and I didn't know what it was, and I was just thinking, this drummer is so fantastic. Like, I can't wait to get home and transcribe this guy and look up who this is. And of course, it's Dom Whale. So it's so comforting to me that I'm taking lessons from the first person I ever listened to. It's like, I have to learn the notes that this guy's playing, because he already had them written down for me. It was really great. But we've got some great musicians here, and I'm really grateful to be at ASU and be surrounded by some of these musicians that have been a huge influence on me listening without even knowing it. So the next tune that we're going to be playing tonight is from another artist that has heavily influenced me, John Mayer. Who's not a jazz artist, but I really respect his pop playing, and we're going to be playing Stop This Turn, as done by Joshua Redman. And I figured if Joshua Redman's okay with playing John Mayer, then I thought it was okay if we did it too. So, enjoy. Thank you. Horace Silver tune, the Cape Verdean Blues. I thought that was kind of a fun, both Latin-y chart and still had a really nice blues feel. Those that know me well know I really love the blues. So the next chart we're going to be playing is titled Emily. My wife's name is Emily. And that's actually what got me interested in the chart to begin with. I had actually never heard the tune and just came across it in a book. It's like, oh, that sounds really cool. So I tried playing through it and I ended up really loving it as a ballad. So I figured it was very fitting. I got married, 7 months ago? 8 months ago? Somewhere there? Do I have? I just can't do math on the spot here. It's 7 months. 7 months. 7 months, 1 week. So yeah, we'll be playing Emily for you now.
Thank you.
Since I heard Dave Brubeck play, it's like, man, everything works. He plays as a jazz tune, and you know, Joe Morello plays it as a solo. I thought it was really great. So, when my sister got married in Australia last year, I had to fly a lot, and so I just took this recording and transcribed the whole thing. What I played for you isn't the exact transcription, but I had a lot of fun transcribing Joe Morello's version of Shortened Bread. So now we're going to move on to another piece titled El Sol Rosado, which is something that I wrote last year. It's a Latin chart, and I found a love for Latin music through, who I mentioned, Joe Gogoli and Don Moyo, who both are really into that kind of music, and I have learned to love it, so some of my favorite things that I've composed have all been in that style, and so enjoy El Sol Rosado. Thank you. us for a tune tonight. We have Afton Martindale. It's going to be singing with us on The Sunny Side of the Street. First of all, thank you to my incredible band. These are all my first pick musicians for this evening, and they've done a wonderful job for me, so thank you. I've had the opportunity of hearing them all play, and every single time I've ever been to a recital or anything they've played on, it's always like, yeah, these guys are going somewhere. So it's a privilege for me to get to share the stage with them this evening. And then, of course, I'd like to thank my wife, who's been so supportive in getting all this put together and has just allowed me to live the dream as long as possible. So thank you, Emily, for being so supportive. And of course, my family. My mom flew all the way in from Pennsylvania just for this occasion, so I really appreciate her being here because she's been so supportive. Don Moyo here, as well as like Mike Coker and Jeff Lipman. I don't know who else from the ASU faculty is here, and Joe Gogley is here. But all killer musicians, all people I would look up to even if I wasn't a student at ASU. And I've learned so much from being there. And I don't know what the future holds for me, but no matter what, I know that my education is better because of the people that I've surrounded myself with. So I'm really grateful for the staff that has been part of my life. All the other beautiful people here that decided to come out to a night of music and are so supportive of me and of live music, because you know, without you, this wouldn't happen. So thank you all for being here and being able to listen to the things that we all want to share with you. So give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you. To finish up this evening, we'll be playing a tune by Thelonious Monk entitled Rhythm and Name. And this is a special song for me because the first album that I really fell in love with was Live at the It Club. And I have every single chart on that memorized. I love Thelonious Monk to the point that I'm really hoping that we can add a middle name or something to a future child of Thelonious. I'm sure they will never, ever go by that. But Thelonious Monk has made a huge impression on me, and even more so when Mike Coker really dove into Thelonious Monk a couple of years ago in the improv class, and I was just blown away at the things that he has left the world of music with. And so I hope that we can give you our own interpretation of Rhythm and Name. Thank you all again for being here, and I look forward to seeing you all in the future. Lots of great jazz that's happening all the time. Thank you to the Nash for having me. I appreciate it.